From the midterm elections to other stories making headlines across the U.S., Congressman Steve Cohen often weighs in on his social media.
A representative from Memphis is running, of course, for re-election against Republican Charlotte Bergmann and independent Leo Awgowhat. And I don't know, you said Steve Cohen was outspoken? What? How are you?
Good, thank you.
Always good to have you back.
Thank you. It's good to be with y'all.
Word is that the administration, while continuing to talk about the red wave, is quite concerned about a blue wave. What are you hearing? Because we don't always trust polls anymore.
Well, I believe, and a certain basis of my knowledge is polls, but also what I hear from colleagues, mm-hmm. is that we will take the House. The issue is the Senate, and that's going to be closer, and it may be more difficult for us to take it. And that'd be unfortunate, in my opinion. Mm-hmm. But I think we will take the House, and we'll take it with a pretty good margin.
Are you concerned, though, Congressman, about actually who will get out and vote Tuesday? Again, what we saw, obviously, a couple of years ago, you did not see as many millennials voting. Mm-hmm. You didn't see a lot of women voting. What do you think will happen this time around? And what are the issues you think?
I think women have gotten out and exercised their right. I think they've seen this president as being abhorrent to their basic values of civility and concern for children and concern for equality and fairness with women. I think they've gotten out and voted. Millennials have not gotten out in great numbers, and they're the worst voting demographic there is. People under 30 and under 40 have not been voting like the people would hope they would. The Hispanics have not come out and voted like people thought they might. So that's important. This election comes down to turnout, and it's always turnout, but Shelby County can make the difference in these races.
Yeah.
Shelby,
as you know, though, there are some who say the president does have quite a number of female voters out there who support him, and there are a number of Latinos also who support him. What do you say to that?
There are always women and Latinos who don't get it.
We'll leave it at that. So isn't that typical, though? I mean, you have a long history. Young people typically don't vote. This isn't really unusual that this generation of young people don't get out.
Young right? people generally don't vote. They have more life expectancy, and they therefore the policies and the laws affect them more than any other group, especially
so
in the environment.
Vote more.
The environment. But they don't think they're going to need health care. They think
right.
they're healthy and they're not going to need health care.
Right.
What does get them activated is marijuana policy, because they could go to jail and lose their liberties, and that gets a lot of young people to vote.
And Barack Obama was not popular with his policy on marijuana laws.
He wasn't. I mean, he was better than Trump, but he wasn't as good as he should have been.
Locally also, Congressman, what are your thoughts on another issue that a lot of people here, especially in Memphis, Shelby County, have been looking at and discussing: instant runoff voting?
Mm-hmm.
Where do you stand on that?
I'm against all three of the charter amendments. They are power grabs by the city officials to try to extend their terms for an extra 4 years rather than limit their terms, which is the way the ballot looks. It's like I'm voting for term limits. The public's already voted for two term limits on the mayor and the council. This is a way to make it three terms, so the present council is trying to give themselves an extra term, rather, so it's diluting the voters, and I'm against it mostly because it is just dishonest. It's political chicanery. I'm not that much in favor of term limits, but the public is. They've done it, and you don't try to put something out that's a deceit on the people.
And
Irv saves money. In runoff elections, in district races, nobody ends up voting. And so it's not a democracy at play. If you have the instant runoff elections, you save money and you're more likely to get somebody who's representative of the community.
Do you agree that it is unethical for Memphis money, city money, to be used in the campaign to educate?
I think it is. Obviously, Chancellor Kyle thought the law was different.
Right. Or said we can address it after the election. Didn't exactly rule on the merits of whether the argument was correct.
Well, ruling after is like the horse is out of the stable. The city shouldn't be doing that. It's just that, and then the three councilmen that got elected to countywide office and didn't resign until now. One of them's resigned in November 1. The other two are staying on and collecting their checks and double dipping.
We talked about that a lot on Live at 9.
It used to be double dipping was a big deal. Now nobody thinks anything about it. They're saying to the voters, we don't want you to elect our successor, and we want you to give whoever's in there an extra term and make you think it's term limits, and we want you to elect people in district races that may be 1,000 people aside. It's just the worst government you can imagine.
All right, Congressman
and
Steve.
As far as the women and the Hispanics for Trump, yeah, they're women for Trump, but they're the traditional, you know, Ozzie and Harriet housewife women, And they follow him. They're for him. They may be pro-life. That's a different issue, and that's something where they're for Trump.
You don't think you're stereotyping some of them?
Well, some of them to extent, but 60% of women that have come out are voting against Trump and don't like him and find him despicable. Hispanics, I don't think there are going to be too many for him, but you never know.
All right,
but I urge everybody to vote.
Thank you
everybody
very much for being here.
Vote.
We appreciate it.
If you don't vote, you can't complain.
And we do want to let you know, a couple of weeks ago, we had Charlotte Bergmann also on Live at 9 as well to hear her point of view.